Hey, it's Patti Scharf, CPA and co-founder of Catching Clouds, the leader in e-commerce accounting. And today's video is going to be on Zapier. I'm really excited about this one. So make sure you stick around to the end because I got some deals and some special like events coming up that I want to tell you about. So, but let's just get started. So I've known about Zapier for the past, I don't know, 2 or 3 years. I've had a couple of Zaps that I had set up, but I really didn't have time to dive into it. And a couple of weeks back, we went to the accounting salon, which I talked about in an earlier video. And they had like a little session on Zapier and it reinvigorated me. And I started diving deeply into Zapier. And I'm so glad that I did. I'm like so geeking out on this. It's like kind of ridiculous. I'm such a dork. But I wanted to share it with you guys. So if you want to improve the automation in your company, this is the way to go. So I think the best way actually to learn about some of the functionality of Zapier is just to show by example. So I'm going to just show you a couple of Zaps that I have set up that might be able to help you out. So as you know, I create YouTube videos, and what I was finding is every time I would create a video, I would publish it up to the YouTube channel. And then, you know, it's not enough to just post it there. You have to actually tell people that it exists. So every time I would post a video, I would also share it on social media. I would tweet it out as Catching Clouds, as Catching Clouds Academy. I would post it on LinkedIn, yada, yada, yada. Sometimes I would forget to post it on a particular channel or whatever. Anyway, I created a Zap, and here's what it looks like. So every time a new video is posted on YouTube, that's the trigger event, and then it will post it in Slack so that my team knows that we uploaded a new video. They can go up on there, they can watch it, they can share it, like it, whatever. Then I will also send it out to Google+. I will send it out through tweet on Catching Clouds. I will send it, I will post it on Facebook, another tweet, LinkedIn, my own other LinkedIn account, and then I'll create an Asana task for the other stuff that's not automated so that I remember to go in and pin it to Pinterest and share it in our Facebook groups. So all of that used to take me anywhere from 15 minutes to like half an hour every time I did a video. So I have this one little Zap set up and boom, done instantly, and it's just amazing. I love it. Okay. The reason why these all look like the same application, by the way, is we have HubSpot. And so I have everything go through HubSpot so that all of the like performance can be tracked and I can see how different channels are doing and things like that. So there you go. And then my other one, so you'll see that one has like 8 different tasks. This one has 24 because I just kind of went hog wild on this. So if you didn't know, I have some online courses, accounting for Amazon, accounting for Shopify. You can find links to those down below if you're interested in those. And so what happens is when, so I have those posted on Teachable, and anytime there's a sale on Teachable, I will rip out the name of the person. I will add them to HubSpot so that I will add that like what course they purchased so that I have that information in my CRM, in my customer relationship management tool. Then I've got these handy dandy paths. So if they sign up for a Facebook group, what happens is I add it to a little spreadsheet, but then I will also send myself a notification in Slack, just kind of giving me a heads up that somebody's going to be going to the Facebook group pretty soon, and I need to go look and see if they've answered the 3 questions so that I can admit them to our group. By the way, if you don't know about our groups, we've got a Facebook community for e-commerce sellers. We have another one for e-commerce accountants. Go check the links down below for those. Okay, so that's path A. If they, however, buy a course, then they go through this different Zap where it kind of restructures how the formatting is, because Teachable, it comes over like $39,000 when it's $399. So I changed the formatting so that it looks better and it can actually be usable. Then I automatically create an invoice in Xero so that I know that we sold a course. We're going to be collecting money on that soon. Then if they use Stripe, then I will have them go look for the charge and pull out the zip code, because Teachable does not collect the addresses of my students. And for any of you who know anything about the new sales tax rules, I need to know where my students are, like where they're buying these courses, so that if I have to collect sales tax, I know what to do. Okay. I throw that information into a spreadsheet and then I post myself a message in Slack notifying me, hey, we sold the course. Yay. All right. And then if they use PayPal, it goes through basically the same thing, only it gives me information about the PayPal ID and stuff instead of the Stripe ID. As you can see, this stuff is really powerful because Zapier can like take all these different tools and connect them together. So one event happens and a cascading effect of automation occurs and you don't have to lift a finger. So I love it super much. So I highly recommend that if you are not familiar with this tool, you go check it out. There is one little warning I want to give you. I know that if you are new to this e-commerce thing, if you haven't taken my Accounting for Shopify course, or if you haven't watched the YouTube video on Shopify, which you should go watch, you're going to see that Shopify is one of the apps that Zapier integrates with, and you will be tempted to integrate that Shopify app with your QuickBooks Online or with Xero so that you can have that information posted as sales occur. Be very, very careful with that, because if you are planning on growing at all, you're going to be doing yourself a disservice. Go watch that video and you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. So this was just a taste of what Zapier can do, but if you want to know actually how to use it, my buddy Jay Kimmelman is going to be going over the basics of Zapier in a webinar tomorrow, sponsored by Elephant Training. So make sure you go check that out. If you want some more in-depth training and you really want to like roll up your sleeves and get in there, Heather Satterley is doing a workshop. Actually, it just started last Friday and I am in it. So if you want to join me and go through it, just send an email to Heather Satterley. I have her email address down below. She can manually add you to the course. And I've got a coupon down below for $50 off of her course if you would like to attend. If you can't make this one, then you can just use that $50 towards one of the next courses and stuff. I know she's got some cool ones coming up over the next few months or so. So make sure you check that out. And if you want to go through the one that she's doing now that I'm a part of and you want to come through it with me, cool. Even though you missed the last one on Friday, she's got a copy of the video in her Slack channel that she has for the group. So don't worry about that. So I hope you got something out of this video. I was not paid as a sponsor for any of these people. I just really super geek out on automation and stuff and making things really easy. If you like this video, please like, comment, and share. If you haven't already, please subscribe, and I will catch you later.